You may be working with colleagues on a document in Pages, and you need to keep track of changes made from one version to another. You can easily do it in Pages. If you go to Edit, Track Changes, now everything you'll be doing is going to be tracked by Pages. You can also click the View icon in the upper left and select Show Comments and Changes pane. And this will be a summary of all the changes you make. So when you're adding new words, deleting sentences, adding new sentences, even spaces and so on, it's being tracked in the pane on the left. It shows up who made the changes, what was changed, whether the next person can accept them or reject them. In addition to tracking your changes, you can also add comments to the document by clicking and selecting a space or a word or section, selecting the comment at the top, or going to Insert Comment and typing your information. Then you click Done or Enter. And then if there is a comment already, you can click Reply and then write your comment. And another person could do the same. Finally, you can also highlight section of your document by selecting the text and clicking on the highlight at the top left, or going to Insert and Highlight. And this really helps emphasize sections of your document. Now, at any point in time, if you want to stop the tracking, pause it for a second, because you're making some changes that are just obvious, you don't need to track them, you can click in the upper right the option to pause your tracking and then make your changes. And then that part will not be tracked. If you open a document and there's no pane showing on the left, you can also go to View, Show Comments and Changes pane. And now if you hover over each of the comments, you can see a squiggly line linking to the section where the change is taking place. Now, if there's a comment, in addition to just the squiggly line, you also have the square showing up. And if the pane is closed, you can hover over the square and read the comment. If you open a track document and you see the pane open, you can accept each of the changes or reject them. And that makes the change final. Now, there are three different ways of viewing a track document: markup, markup without deletion, or final. If you click the markup, which is the default, basically you see all the changes in the doc. If you click on the markup without deletion, all the deleted section will be hidden. And you can also select the final version. Maybe you just want to see exactly how the document will look after all the changes are finalized and accepted. If you hover over the top icon in the right, you can also accept or reject all the changes quickly and change the color for the author of the track changes. That change will also apply to all the changes you already made. If at any point you want to modify the way your name appears in track changes, or you want to change the author's name, you can go to Pages Setting and scroll down to the bottom and update the name. And this will update the name retrospectively. If you look at the pane on the left, you will see that all the comments are sorted by default by page number, but you can also sort it by date. Maybe already this is your second take of the document and you just want to look at the most recent changes. You can sort it by date. You can also filter by author and only see comments made by certain person. Finally, you can hide comments or changes in the document and focus on one or the other. Now, Pages is able to track a lot of changes you make to the document. However, it doesn't track everything. For example, it does not track changes if you change a color of a text. It also doesn't track if you remove an object or a picture in your document. And if you're using tables in Pages, any of the text or numbers or data that you have there, it's also not tracked if someone changes it. Finally, what's really interesting is if you're using layout in Pages or text boxes in your document, Pages does track the text that's being changed inside the text box. However, if you have a finalized text box and someone removes the entire text box, none of it's going to be tracked in Pages. If you're working with colleagues who are using Microsoft Word, this should not prevent you from using Pages, because you can export your document to Word and you will keep all your track changes, and your colleagues will be able to see all the track changes and accept them in Microsoft Word. Now, at any point, if you're done with making changes, you want to turn off the tracking, you can go to Edit, Turn off tracking. And at this point, you can either reject all changes or accept all the changes to finalize the document. Now, one thing that will still be there are comments and highlights. You will have to resolve them individually in order to clear them. If either you or someone else accepts all the changes in the document and you want to go back and see what was changed, there's an easy way to do it in Pages. You go to File, revert to and select the browse versions. You can see the versions of the document and you can click the one you want and restore. Or you can select the less open or less saved version and revert to previous copy of the document. Finally, you not always can get back to the previous version of the document to see the changes. What happens if you have the original document and the final one and you want to see what changes, you don't want to have to do it manually? You can use CopyLeaks text comparison tool, which basically lets you compare two different files. But you have to convert the pages document to Word first because it doesn't accept pages. So once you convert it to Microsoft Word, you can just drag the two documents to compare in the tool. And then you will see all the sections that are the same and all the sections that are different. This tool also shows changes such as changes to a table or when objects are removed, etc. So thanks so much for watching.